So if this building plus operates as 197, then there's no way that another mission can take money. Every time I explain this, I'm not sure why they don't understand it. Okay? Over here is the Bozba. The Bozba is supposed to be, is there to help schools, whatever they need. If they need help with curriculum, they contact Cody and say, okay, this school needs help. If the school boards need help with training, Cody provides them, the Bozba provides some training. So they're still here. The school boards are still right here. Okay, there's Shiprock, Crown Point, Fort Defiance, Chimney to the city. This hasn't been determined yet how the school boards are going to be. We might leave it the same. We might change it. But we're going to change it. We have to do your, we have to get your input. What do you guys think about it? That's what this graph means. Let me explain this in more detail. This is our 30 plus. 30 plus is here. Remember I said it's going to operate school operations. Human resources would be right here. Finance, school governance, and academics. All this is going to be housed in the 30 plus. So like Fahadulay, let me use Fahadulay for example. We're going to have what we call Navajo education centers. This is just a plan, it's not in place yet, because we have to get input from everyone. Crown Point will be the nearest one for Fahadulay. So if Fahadulay wants to hire some teachers, they want to hire a consultant, all they have to do is go to Crown Point and get them, they don't have to go all the way to Winderock. I know there's a lot of comments saying we have to go all the way to Winderock to get things done. They don't care. They can go to Winderock or Crown Point. There's going to be 17 schools that will be overseen by Crown Point. We don't know the number of school board members. Okay? So we're going to have 5 educational resource centers all over the nation. We'll be working with the schools. This is what the request is going to look like. That's just a suggestion. It's not set in stone. Any questions, concerns? I know the gentleman had a hand up a bit.
Sorry, I want to apologize. I came a little late, so I was here early this morning. But my question is, Kortile School and all these other grand schools, Biai schools, we need to stop comparing it to Navajo Prep. From my understanding, Navajo Prep is like a private school. They screen their students and they got to pass a test to be accepted. Kortile Community School is open to every kid. You don't turn away, so we need to get away from that. You know, compared to Navajo Prep.
Okay, if you notice in my presentation when I brought on Navajo Prep, I didn't really talk about the academics because that's where they bring in top-notch students. But as far as their finance, they're top-notch. They turn in their papers on time, they turn in their documents on time to the government. Why is that? But some schools in Arizona, they have a hard time turning in those documents. They have a hard time turning in their audits. Why is that? It's not because of their students. It's because the CEO works really well with the board. That's why it gets done. When they want to hire, they work with the board. So when I presented Navajo Prep, I only looked at school governance. I only talked about school governance. I talked about human resources, and I talked about finance when I talked about Navajo Prep. I didn't talk about the academics because that is true, what you said. But those other 3 things, they're perfect at. Richfield, too, they're perfect at that. Because their CEO works really well with their with the school board. They don't have these problems. Okay?